Good day and welcome back to another week of Talking Technical. And what a market do we have? I mean, everybody is just buying this market. We talked about it a long time that some of our local shares are cheap and everybody said, no, it's not cheap and things are this and that and the other. And against all odds, our market really catch some wind behind it. And I think some of the overseas investors are starting to come back. But and the rand is also strong. Everything is just blowing the wind. I mean, if you think about it, the rand, can you believe it? Close to 18 rand, and we've got an election ahead, and everybody was scared about it. But I'm a little bit nervous because if you look at these charts, there will be a nice feature that you will see, and you will see that a lot of these charts really had some wonderful rallies. As subscribers to our services, some of the candle of the day subscribers are just so happy because we had such wonderful calls. I mean, Old Mutual from 10 to 11 in a matter of a few days. I'm not talking about Impala that someone quickly came into action, gave us 5-6% somewhere in a day or two. There's so many of them. Sabania, I mean, all those shares, just when we called it, it was like early breaks and it just rushed off. And I know it's not always that easy. And that's why I've got a few nice charts here to carry on today. Well, let's have a look at Anglo American Platinum. You all know that BHP Billiton is keen to buy Anglo American Platinum, Anglo American. And they said there's only two shares that they don't want, or two companies that they don't want. They don't want Kumba Iron Ore, and they don't want Anglo Plats. But if I look at this chart, suddenly there's a bit of nervousness around it. This major gap was formed on the announcement, and that gap is between 51547 and it will close at 58288. Now, if you look at this chart, what this chart is telling me is that there's still a bit of optimism around, but I don't like this. This is a tiny little double top here, and we may be right or maybe wrong, but I'm just nervous that that deal will fall through. Because if that deal falls through, we can easily see this window to close. So for me, it's quite simple. While we're doing this, some people will say, but Franz, look at this. This is just a straightforward flag formation. Nothing is wrong here. It's just a matter of time, and then we can kick in and look at this flag formation or this bullish flag that everybody's talking about. For me, it is quite simple. For me, it is maybe a double top. We're a little bit nervous here, and the clue is this gap, and that gap is opening up at 58288. We can reach for this gap. So I think if you want to buy, it's maybe a little bit late to buy now because we don't know. There is an offer on the table. And Anglo American said, no, but that's not enough. We want more money for that. So I'm a little bit nervous that everybody's in this boat, and this boat is consolidating, and this boat makes me a little bit nervous because all the other commodity stocks, they are rallying, but they haven't got a rally behind them with a rumor. They rally because of the commodity prices that are doing well. So just be a little bit careful, but of course, I can be wrong. And where will this chart show me that it can go up again? There's the resistance line, and that resistance line will break above 64683. And there's a lot of people that say that this chart can actually go to 800 Rand because they think that Billiton will pay 800 Rand. But can you hear my word? I say think. And that's always the case. Be a little bit nervous. If you get onto the boat, maybe a little bit late, and then you burn your fingers, and that's also not a good thing. Let's have a look at PPC, a local company, and if everybody is correct, and if this local economy of ours can maybe show a little bit of oomph, we will probably see it in shares like PPC and some of the other industrial shares. That there's the resistance for you. For me, I like this chart, and the reason why I like it, it's all higher lows. Look at it. There's the low, higher low, higher low, higher low. Two strong candles, but we need to get above this resistance, and that resistance sits at 3 rand and 58 cents. Above 3.58, this higher low can turn into a higher high, and that of course is positive. And some guys will say, but Franz, you missed something out. There's a double bottom here as well. And this double bottom will also turn into a positive above 358. So above 358, we can maybe see a double bottom coming into play. Let's do a projection there. If that is correct, above 358, the double bottom can kick in. And where can we go? Let's have a look. It can go all the way to that previous high of 390. But for me, this 50-day moving average, I think, will be my stop loss. The stop loss will be at 334. Because remember, all these charts showed some strong rallies over the last couple of weeks, days. And you can easily see that it can pull back rapidly and maybe even showing us an inverse head and shoulder. There's the left shoulder, there's the head, and then maybe working on the right shoulder to kick up. So I will say buy above 358, stick to your stop loss of the 50-day moving average, and hopefully it can go all the way up to 390. Let's have a look at Signia. Now, Signia is one of those companies that everybody loves. I mean, they are wonderful fund managers. And the share, I mean, had a beautiful rally. It came from, can you believe it, in January. The share was as low as 1753. And the share is now ticking around 21 Rand. But what I don't like is, look at these candles. These candles are telling us something. These candles say, we open up at a certain level, and suddenly we sell off all the way to close. And for the last couple of days, this is exactly what we've seen. And look at this lower shadow. That tells you that is supporting the share price. But for me, if you've got Signia, I'm going to draw a little line in here. And I mean, this is a wonderful company, and they are brilliant fund managers. But for me as a trader, below 20 Rand and 97 cents, I will get a little bit nervous on the stock. And I will say to myself, maybe the rally was just too steep. Remember, Signia, Sanlam, Old Mutual, all these companies, Momentum, they are proxies of the market. Usually if the market do well, they do well. Usually if the market struggles a little bit, the share price struggles a little bit. So for me, below 2097, it will send out a hint. Maybe the share rallied too far. And maybe the market also rallied too far. So use this as your guideline. If you want to look at Signia and you want a clue, below 2097, this share can maybe show us some weakness. And don't be surprised, it can easily come back to this 50-day moving average. Look what happened in the past. Every time that it got to this 50-day moving average, there was some buyer supporting the stock. So it can maybe pull back to 1986. I'll be a little bit nervous to short the stock, and the reason why I will say that, because the world is just so bullish on interest rates that the world believe that interest rates can just go lower and it cannot go up. And that makes me a little bit nervous. I always nervous if everybody is on one side of the story. I sometimes believe that is maybe not the right thing, but we don't know. The market will show us. Let's have a look at Kell Group, and that is quite simple. I mean, this stock, beautiful rally. And if you look at it, I mean, since March, from 37.58 to 48 Rand, beautiful rally. I will get a little bit nervous because this is, for me, a possible shooting star. And what makes me a little bit nervous, can you see there's a little bit of a gap here? Now, this gap is a classic breakaway gap. And that gap sits between 47 Rand and 46 Rand 86. So if this tiny little gap closes, or we see an ugly bearish engulfing candle, the shooting star can maybe become an evening star reversal. And that makes me a little bit nervous. So for me, I'm a little bit nervous. For me, I will personally look at this level, and there's the level. But it's so close to that gap, in actual fact, you can use the gap. Let's use the gap below that level of 46.86. This share can maybe surprise and easily pull back, because this candle here already was a warning that there were some keen sellers around that was keen to sell into strength. So just be a little bit nervous. It can easily also pull back to the 50-day moving average, waiting at 41.57. Now, it doesn't sound a lot. That's almost 6 Rand on a 47 Rand share. That's almost 10 Rand. Let's have a look at Tokyo Gas. And why I'm showing this Everybody is chasing the other commodities. And everybody is so keen that the other commodities can just go up. But natural gas is a different story. Natural gas is still in the doldrums. Natural gas is struggling. And if I look at this company, yes, everybody will say, France, there is a head and shoulder here. But can you remember, it wasn't a few months ago I showed a head and shoulder formation on the platinum price. And I said, I doubt if it will go below the neckline because there's a lot of mines already not making money. And that they're in trouble and they're retrenching people and they close shafts. And that is always a sign that maybe there's a turnaround coming. Now, if you look at natural gas, Tokyo Gas, they're selling natural gas. If you look at Tokyo Gas, look at this massive gap to the top. For me, a speculative buy above this level. I'm going to give you the level there. There you are, a speculative buy above 1126. I'll make use of a stop loss of $10.64. And I mean, look at these gaps. This gap is between 1130 and there's a tiny little dash candle, 1144. And then it can either go also up to, can you believe it, 1166. And this is the big gap. This is actually the gap that this share can chase. When the momentum in natural gas picks up, we can easily see this gap. And this gap is between 1209. And 1263. So yes, it can go to 1263. Stick to your stop loss. Your stop loss is 1064. And maybe it can surprise us all, wait and bounce. But of course, we need the natural gas probably above $2.18, $2.2. Then we can maybe see these shares suddenly to surprise. I mean, can you believe silver? We looked at it a while back. We never thought that it can give us such a rally. And in 4 or 5 days, it rallied almost 10-12%. So it just shows you if commodities start to go, the world can really be surprised to the top. Let's have a look at the Dow Jones. Now, the Dow Jones, for the first time in history, it hit, can you believe it, 40,000. And everybody's just so happy. But what I see is, look at the 50-day moving average. We're a little bit ahead of the 50-day. And this market sometimes rally quite a long time with the 50-day moving average, but eventually it pulls back. So I wonder if we're not at the point now where the market has rallied a little bit too far above the 50-day moving average. And that's actually the feature that I would like to discuss today. Always remember, when a formation or a chart rally away from the 50-day moving average, it's like this. Even if it falls below that, there you are, you can see. If it falls too far below it, suddenly it starts to move up. If it moves too high above it, it usually climb back, crawl back. Even there, you will say, oh, France, but it never came there. It took a while, but look what happened. After a few months, it corrected all the way back below that. So this 50-day moving average is always acting as like a magnet. And when the price just rallies away too far above it, yes, it's fine. But for me, if you look at this chart, everything is positive. Momentum is to the top. And for me, I'll only get nervous when this previous high, there's the high. I just want to draw in a line there. There's the high. The moment the Dow Jones Industrial Index starts to go below 39889, that's about 130 points from here. We can maybe see a pullback all the way down to the 50-day moving average. And let's close off the show with platinum. Everybody's into platinum now. Everybody believes that the platinum price can just go up. Nothing can stop it. I'm a little bit nervous. A rally from $900 to $1,079 in a matter of 14 or 15 trading days makes me a little bit nervous. And look at that shooting star candle that already tells you that there were some guys around here selling some stock. But for me, I will look at this price. And there's two warning signals. The one is below that low of that candle. I will give the level there. And the next one is this. And there you are. If this resistance, 1095, that becomes, 1072. If 1072 becomes a resistance, that's not positive. But for me, the turnaround will be below the low of that candle, 1051. And where can we go to? I know nobody will believe me, but we can maybe pull the way all the way back to this 50-day moving average. Just be a little bit nervous. We had some great moves here. Everybody's into platinum. If there's people starting to sell, we can maybe be surprised that some people would love to lock in profits at these nice levels that they've seen over the last couple of days. Thank you for visiting the show. Thank you for becoming a subscriber. Visit our website, www.fransdeklerk.com, for more info, or you can even drop Christelle an email at admin@fransdeklerk.com. All the best. See you.